Да, я там привыкла подглядывать, а тут
подглянешь.
Давайте еще раз микрофон дадим.
Я потом скажу.
Ну все, погнали, да?
Да. Hello, dear friends. Today with us is someone who definitely can be considered a real artist in our dancing form, and everything about him talks for that. Even the way he walked into this room this morning already was showing that this interview will be quite special. Please welcome Sharunas.
Hello, Sarunas.
Hello. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning, guys.
Just a little remark. He put immediately his music and we were already dancing with the Russian songs. It was actually very nice and thank you for the good mood straight away.
Thank you for coming. And let's start our interview with the first question.
I thought you were going to say with champagne. Just kidding.
Can do this.
So the first question is, who are you? Please describe yourself.
Wow, you just like bang.
That's the point. This is what we're doing here.
That's why I told you that no one is sleeping on our interview. Everyone starts to sweat.
The best part I think of this whole thing is that I really have no clue what's coming, you know? So I like the feeling of not knowing what's coming. In what sense, I mean, okay, who am I? I think I'm a lot of things and personalities at the same time in a way, because I have to play different roles. That's how I see it. Not that none of them is real, because if you say I play a role, it might feel like, oh, that's not him. Actually, all of them is fully me. And I consider myself a dancer, a husband, a father, a teacher, a friend, and the list goes on, you know. I try to be inspirational to people, and you know, a son. So in a different role, in a way, I assume I'm slightly different, but at the same time something really combines it all. So it's quite a wide range. I would not say that I'm a dancer and that's it, because that would somehow, to me, that would put a limitation.
That's very nice. Actually, a very interesting answer, yeah. Because we ask too many people this question.
It's interesting to see that everybody describes themselves different.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And tell us a little bit about your childhood, because I think not many people know where you come from. Do you have a full family? Brothers, sisters, maybe?
Probably not too many people know. I was originally born in Lithuania, in a relatively small town. And my childhood was good. It was fun, in a sense that we have been doing things that probably these days not too many kids do. But I grew up a lot in nature, and doing things that probably a lot of us kids did sometime, you know, like playing outside, you know, and doing all sorts of crazy things that probably these days it's a bit too much and over the top, but we did a lot of crazy stuff. But very natural in that sense, not so much squeezed into some frames of general understanding. That's why when I started go to school, I straight away got into big, big, big troubles.
Why?
Yeah.
Because, I mean, in those days, I think the general education system, although probably these days is still probably the same, is like, they have standards. And the minute you don't fit into that standard, they got a problem. Especially if the people are not very highly intelligent, mm-hmm. they don't know how to cope with it.
Yes.
So they say, you're wrong.
Yes.
And that's it. You know, and then I was wrong for 3-4 years in a big time. And the problem was that my mom was a school teacher in the same school.
Okay.
So she was like with a red face every other day because, you know, it's constantly reporting, you know. But as I look at it, that was not my problem at all, you know.
So for example, if you can go that way deeper, what were you doing that they weren't considering you to be a naughty kid?
I mean, I give you a small story. Can you imagine, this is 1st of September, the very first grade. So I went to school for first time in my life with a flower. You know what I'm talking about. And then there is normally a parade.
Yes.
You know, the kids go with holding hands around the school, and then the school director speaks like this. So I said, my mom is in the same school, right? So they go into this parade, and she's standing with her class and looking, and like the school is like a round shape, it's an inside garden, and they're looking that way from the stage into this. And she sees on a third floor, standing on the window like this, watching the ceremony, who? Me. Because the teacher already locked me in and said, you're not gonna go to parade. And she saw me only first day, you know, but I remember that. So here was a good start to know that your teacher will lock you in, you know. For these days, that would be so wrong, you know, you yes, would be almost like sued or something like that, you know. But I was doing a lot of things, you know, you just, in class, you just can't still, you know, you like the girl, you do something, you think this guy doesn't know the answer, you tell the answer. So it's just like, it's just, I find naughty and active kids, you know, who actually in a way are probably more special and talented, and they see the world just in a different way instead of being suppressed. So I just had a lot of energy, I would say that way. And that caused me a lot of troubles. And my mom probably.
So you just mentioned that your mom is a school teacher.
Yeah, she's been a school teacher for probably, I don't know, 19 years or something like that, maybe less, I might be wrong.
And what relationship you have with your mother?
Very good. My mom and dad, they're still together, and I would say it's just different type of relationship with me and my father, and me and my mom. Both are close, but in a different way. I can't explain it. It's just a little bit different vibe, like today somebody would say, you know. But both are good and caring. Maybe because my father is very macho and very sort of like disciplined and everything, so he has this certain vibe so that you're not, you know, although I'm not serious with him, that's my secret, you know, I'm not serious with him, so he's less serious with me, something like that, you know.
Okay, very good. So the next question is,
we wanted to talk with you also about women. How would you describe for you as men, and also you said that your father is quite manly in his approach to life. Who is woman for you in a perfect world? Like, how would you describe this creature?
Well, first of all, guys, two beautiful ladies taking today interview from me, okay? I'm very lucky guy.
He's using his trick right now. Again, he's less serious, so we are less...
Can you repeat the question? You said perfect, or you said best, or how did you say it?
In your perfect world, the way you imagine a woman, who is it? Who is this creature?
You know, it's so hard to explain, because me, myself, I feel... they called me like a weatherman. You wake up in the morning, you don't really know what kind of way you wake up out of bed. Maybe you say that's why, where art comes in. Yeah. So for me, actually, it's changing. So you see, this is the beauty of it. I find that if I will say to you now that, for example, I like my woman, okay, let's say even physically, I say I like blonde or I like brunette, and that's it. And I only have that. But actually, it's not. And it depends really what we're talking about. If we're talking about a physical look or a personality or a combination, you know. So in my perfect world, if we're talking about the relationship, is really maybe being able to be transformative, adaptable to different circumstances. And then when the vibe changes, that you can naturally also change your own vibe instead of being insistive that I'm like that and I'm not changing. So that sort of stubbornness for me is a little bit and intelligent, because there is a lot of fun in changing, in my opinion, mm-hmm. in my opinion. And I like fit ladies, I will be very honest. I appreciate beauty in my own way, and like I say, it could be very different directions and styles, and if I feel like this is beautiful and somebody would say no, and I would still feel like it's beautiful. And it doesn't matter if it's probably lady or man, I like real, so it's genuine. And a lot of times people don't know what's genuine, I find, you know, so they're still pretending going on and thinking that this is this and this is that. And instead I like more real. Or even if I see that the person, for instance, is on the journey towards getting more real, I always like encourage, because it's very hard to say, you know, in life we arrive to the point where we feel like, oh, now I know, at the very different stages. But as long as people trying to, I always encourage that. And that I appreciate. So what I also really like in women is women who is wants to be a better self than she was yesterday and keep improving and changing and developing. Mm-hmm. That's probably the good word of saying, developing. So it doesn't matter. Like, I always could never understand that people say, oh, so let's say I gave birth, or now I'm this age and I have to look certain way, you know. Like, I really remember when we were kids, if you imagine, let's say, your grandmother, then that's an expectation. That's how people supposed to look of that age. And for instance, I totally disagree. Or maybe the woman will say, you know what, I don't believe in these laws and I want to be like that. And I actually very much congratulate that look, that you break the standards and you actually, I don't want to be like what everybody else thinks me to be, so I be like that. So, and therefore it's real to me.
Kind of with no limits. Woman with no limits in her mind, in her future.
Yeah, I think. Very open.
I describe it like this.
Very open.
I have a little additional question just out of my curiosity. We did not plan that, but you said that you like women to be real in their expression and in everything what they feel or experience. Yeah, it's just now you said.
Yes.
And a little bit beforehand, you said that you like this quality in women to be transformative, to adopt. For example, if she is in the situation that she wants to, not to adopt, but to react instinctively, emotionally, quite active, which of these two qualities would you appreciate more?
For instance, if you say, would I consider that real? And maybe not necessary, because it is real in some way from that person's point of view. Mm-hmm. But if you look at the whole situation, maybe then, for example, if I lose control over myself, a lot of times I end up regretting and disappointed just within my own self. Because actually, when I was younger, I would say, oh, but because this one said that and I said that and I act that way. In the end, when you mature and you become more intelligent, you understand that actually this was totally your own choice, even how to. So when that woman reaches that level of understanding and then she's real, then I appreciate. If not, I have no problem to even help and explain that, listen, actually this is just your own perspective to what's happening, you know.
Okay.
And that's what I'm trying to say, that type of understanding, if you keep growing every day, you could see it, you know, and you can feel it. And yes, some people are very like that, and they call it, this is real me, you know, and then I will be like that. But I often find that this type of people don't go very far, you know, unless they start changing, you know. So that's again this thing about improvement.
And self-growth.
Correct, exactly. I think it's limitless. If when you ask me a question, who am I, it made me think, because if I go deeper in that philosophy, actually I don't know. Because nobody knows. I mean, it's so infinite.
It's good to ask it.
To see where you are right now.
From this perspective, yeah, like that.
If because we are talking about women, let's talk a little bit about your woman. Yeah. So with Victoria, you are together, I think, 16 years. Is it correct?
Yeah, something like that. I'm not very good with numbers. She is very good with numbers.
Okay, we will ask her.
Yeah, but something like that. Definitely in that range.
And definitely it's a long journey, yeah?
Yes.
And you've been through many, many stages. So now my question is, can you put in the order of who is Victoria for you? So you have woman, dance partner, wife, mother of your kid, friend, lover.
She's my partner in crime, I would call. I see it as a journey of what we most people call life, and I chose her to be my partner. So, and together we go through different situations. So it's like a team that is willing to whatever comes across to conquer it. So if we dance together today, we try to dance as good as possible, and we try our best to do that. The child arrives into our life, we together try to be the best parents. When we are together holding hands and walking on a promenade, we try to enjoy that moment as much as possible. When we go to visit her parents, we both trying to be the best kids possible, and so on and so on. So it's like, if we're talking about women in life, and then we're talking about that probably sexual part of it and also relationship part of it, to me it's one out of, like, you know, if you had a big cake and you cut into many slices, it's one slice. And if you asking me which would I put priority, it's not possible, because every single one affects the whole cake. Mm-hmm. And therefore, to me, she's the cake. I always say to her, without you, I would never be able to do what I do or be where I am, and vice versa, I think is exactly the same thing, you know, and that's what makes the good team, I guess. I don't know, whatever you would like to call it. But, you know, when you get together, to me, it's like this, whatever comes, we should be ready to do it together. So that sense of team, I think it should be quite strong. You know, that's what we kind of focus on. And not always working, but it's not ideal.
It's life. It's normal, yeah, that it's not working like this. There is no click button on. Make it perfect now.
This is actually my next question, because for the young generation, and also not young, nowadays pandemic, when some difficult times comes, so many couples split up. Yeah, and what will be your advice as a successful couple on the floor and out of the floor? Because everybody say the basic things, yeah, respect, conversation, talk to each other. Maybe you want to add something else.
I find that these tough times actually show and test, you know. So they test the relationships, and they test the partnerships, and they show who is who, in a way, in that sense. And a lot of times the people live in the illusion that they think they are together. Mm-hmm. And then all of a sudden, when you take away something like a competition, it's not even dancing. Because a lot of people say, we love dancing, you know. And maybe they're not. Maybe they're addicted, let's say, to wearing a dress and hairspray and being on the competition floor, you know. So they like a competition. You take one aspect out and you realize that maybe I don't even know this person. Maybe some people very lucky, opposite, they realize, maybe they fall in love even deeper, they get nurtured. And there are probably people who look at it and they're like, oh, I thought that we are like together, and now I realize that actually, what am I doing here? Mm-hmm. You know, so it, and I find that, so for example, if you take our industry, dancing industry, that people probably who are for real reasons doing it because of dancing as itself, mm-hmm, it doesn't matter. I mean, we practiced in Victoria Park for 4 months. And what? Okay, so we cannot travel, you know. But so people who are maybe addicted to you know, videoing themselves when they dance, or maybe they are, you know, and then nothing else is important, or maybe they are after the views on YouTube, or I mean, whatever, or, you know, fame, so-called. We have our little world and we have fame. Mm-hmm. And you would be probably surprised that they are together because they need each other. Of course, if you're not in a couple, you're not competing, nobody even knows you, right? Mm-hmm. So they need someone. But maybe I'm using you for my own benefits and you don't even know it. And maybe it's even happening very subconsciously, not like a person on purposely preparing a plan like that. And that's why when times like that happens, some people wake up and realize that maybe it's not what's happening. So my suggestion is, if you really love dance, what you say, because if you interview like this, everybody will say, I love dance, I love dance. So what is that you love dance? So if you are prepared to really go to that studio every day and analyze, I don't know, your movements, how can I make it better, explore yourself. Then if you really like dance, you maybe also like different directions of dance, you know, and then you try to explore those directions and see how you can put those things into the niche that you are doing, you know, and explore and do things. Then I believe that people are creative and they do it for the reasons because they love dance. Mm-hmm. Otherwise people, for example, Vicky loves competition a lot. She loves dance, but she loves competition. She likes to walk on the floor and feel like she's competing. And there's nothing wrong about it, you know. Correct. So she loves that, you know. I might not, but we both like dance. So when there is no, of course, sometimes, you know, when you are 3 weeks in a row in a studio and then you cannot do one place, it sucks, right? But then at the same time, it always teaches you something, and next day you just get stronger. Again, if you are really like together. Now to find a person like that, people have to be lucky, you know, like I think not only lucky, but like, we all seen some great partnerships, right? Like they dancing wise, they create great product, but then eventually it still goes the other way. So to find a couple that would be really for the right reasons, and not maybe some people, you know, they also stay because of the business, because it's good for business, you know. So I feel very well, I sad for the people because the life is much more than, you know, just doing, you know, the business. So that is rare, you know. I don't know.
Скрипит, шок скрипит на этом, на велюре. Главное, чтобы не заскрипеть вот так. Я сейчас буду поворачиваться в камеру, такая...
А можно? Подожди. Ну ладно. Чего? Окей, ладно, все. Продолжаем. My additional question to you. You explained very good. Why it's happening and how you worked in your couple to make it stick together. But what is your advice, for example, to people who is searching for couple? For example, we have Anya here, for example.
That was actually
not planned at all. But what would you tell her? What she need to
search
in a person that she will say, he's perfect for me. With him, I can make a good long partnership.
Oh, I like this question because the way you explained it, was a very complex answer. I really like the answer.
But then how to search, you know, this is very good answer, well, but then
how to know?
How to know?
Yeah. First of all, you have to ask yourself, why are you in this? You know, so if, like, first of all, find out what is that you want to do, you know? So for example, I don't know, I just want to get famous, or I want to get that certain result, or I'm looking to find somebody that I want to dance for next 20 years and let's say get as best results as possible, you know. But because if you're going to just say for yourself that I want to be, let's say, make this top result or something like that, and you might actually find a partner for that, but it might even take, I don't know, 2 years, and then after, then you're going to be looking for another partner or something like that. So I find that you have to, for your own self, first of all, to know what is that you really after, you know. And if you are, so that depends on the next part of the answer. Let's say what is Anya after?
Yeah.
So then to answer your question is like how she should be looking for that somebody. You see, a lot of people, it's natural. We are all humans, not perfect. Yeah. So what happens is that we all want to, I assume, this was many years ago when I started dancing with Vicky, but I see a tendency that when people split and when they look for partner, they look for someone that is already good or somewhat successful. Mm-hmm. And nobody is looking for somebody who is nobody, so mm-hmm. to speak. I'll put it this way. So I already explained about Aina, but I put it this way. If I would be in my shoes with the knowledge that I have today, I would look for, let's say, a partner mm-hmm. with the qualities of big stamina in here and in body, and prepared to work hard and be open and explore herself in limitless ways and try to become as best dancer as possible, because I know that eventually that will give you good results.
Even if this girl, woman, would be very low level in dancing, low ranking.
Yes. Because it's long run. Like, for example, I'm so confident. Give me a low ranked girl, give me 9 months to 1 year, and you will not recognize her.
Mm-hmm. So you will gonna teach her?
Of course I will show. I have to bring it up to the certain, but I also have to bring it up in a way that it will be suiting what we are doing together. So of course it's a get together, and yes, it is teaching in a way, because of course, if you are planning to compete in that level,
and also you have experience that she don't have yet.
Correct. So this is also very different. If I'm prepared to, like, for example, I've seen also these examples. People fall in love and then maybe somebody is nobody and somebody is somebody, you know, but they dance because they love each other. Okay, so no problem, you know, but you compete in that level of results, but you love each other. For example, I'm talking about a partner that, for example, my goal would be initially to have results and success in the industry. So those would be the qualities, because I'm not looking for love of my life. Maybe she is, I don't know, you know. There would be different priorities.
There will be a lot of misunderstandings on what I'm searching right now.
Yeah, so
thanks
you
to
ask,
you,
you
know, nothing is true. I didn't comment on anything.
That was my question. It wasn't planned, sorry. Yeah, because I had an exam I wanted to ask.
No, but
because it's difficult.
If I ask you now, I don't think you would need even to take time to think of, oh, so what am I really after? Especially, let's say, after I give some examples. Then, and your catalog might be big. I want this, 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 that. Just put it in the right order. It's no problem to want a lot.
But my additional question then on that, because it's very interesting conversation. I truly believe also on what you said, that if you really know the qualities in the dancer that you are searching for your perfect partnership, it doesn't matter which ranking, which qualities he or she is now, it matters on what you see in the body that is possible to develop. But I faced one time the situation that you truly believe and give a chance to a person to really go for it, and you see that the person in the way is not really taking his or her chance on the наделе, on actual actions. Yes, so they can tell you a lot of things, but on real actions.
But that's the whole point. That means they don't have that quality.
Okay,
so a lot of people, yeah, you know that it's no need to give chance to everybody. Not everybody wants. I mean, if you go now to a, let's say, supermarket, and you go to a cashier and say, would you like to be a millionaire? She will say, yes, I do. You know, nobody will say, no, I don't want. That's why they say, yes, I want. But now, does she really do this? I don't know, I'm insecure, I'm da-da-da. That means they don't have those qualities. They have a wish list, but not the qualities. Mm-hmm. So to find somebody who really, and of course you have to test it, you know. So the girl will say, oh yeah, I'm very hardworking. I'm like, yeah, let's see how much you can handle, you know, about hard work, you know.
And so the perception of hard work is very different for everyone.
Exactly. So you test it, and hopefully you can, like I say, you need some luck to actually click. But that's why I think that the first part of knowing of what you want, you will already naturally, in a way, attract the better choice. Is sometimes you are too chaotic in your own understanding what you want. So then it's like, and then you get a bit messy versions, you know, of it. So when you become like, you know, this is what I'm after, I think the right person appears. Like the same, like when the student is ready, the teacher appears, yes. You know.
You do believe in this law of attraction?
I believe, I know that it works, and that's it.
Me too, that's why I asked, yeah.